Hey guys, it's Jake from Metal Wani, and I am here with Tomi Koivusaari from AMORPHIS. Tomi, how are you going?
I'm fine, thank you. Been a few months on like almost like holiday after recording the new album, so now just waiting for the album to get released and getting to gigs, so that feels fine.
Yeah, and we are here to talk about the new album today, so Queen of Time. It's coming out on the 18th of May. Now, I know AMORPHIS has been in the game for a very long time, and I've seen Santeri and Essa also describe the release of an album as more eventful than their own birthday. So how excited is the band to be releasing Queen of Time?
Very excited. I think this is our deepest, I would say, and widest musically, I think, album we have made for a while, and every song turned out very good, we feel like that, and also it's great that Oppu, the original bass player, is back, so now we have like a original lineup in a band, plus two members more, so that feels fine, and also it's great to have Oppu, his playing style is quite different than Niku's, so that brings some new elements to us as well.
Yeah, and that's actually good that you mentioned Oppu, because I know that when he came in for the recording, he came in with a couple of songs, and I think you managed to hold on to one of them as a bonus track on the album, is that correct?
Yeah, that's true, yeah. There is one song, I think he had like three songs, but we always have like so many songs, so we had to drop one when we were rehearsing, because it was so much different kind of song than the others, so, and Jens, the producer, he was choosing the actual songs which came to album, so, but it's good to hope so one song is in a bonus track, it's a great track, I think, and it feels like old AMORPHIS in a way to us.
Yeah, so we'll come back to, you mentioned Jens, and we'll come back to Jens in a little bit, but Under the Red Cloud appeared in a lot of top 10 lists in 2015. Does the band feel any pressure in releasing a new album on the back of such a well-received album?
We try always not to take any pressures, and if we are satisfied by ourselves to album, then it's just like we cannot do anything more than that. So not really, and we feel quite strong about it anyway, and one song what we released already got some great response from the fans, so I think the whole album is as strong as that song, so we feel quite good about it.
Yeah, and it's actually good that you mentioned that, because you did drop the lyric video for the opening track, The Bee, just over a week ago. It's got over 250,000 views on YouTube already, which is really good. It's a phenomenal track, and it's very fluid. It has a really nice flow with it, with the harsh vocals alternating with the clean vocals and the melodies. So you obviously mentioned the reception for the track. Is that as good as you had sort of planned it to have been?
Yeah, definitely. I think the 250,000 times in 1 week, I think it's very good. And it's always, when the song is released and you don't think that much before that how the other people are thinking about the new stuff, but of course it's always great to see when you're like so inside in the record yourself, so we cannot say that much that how it sounds to fans, so it's always great to see some response, and if it's good it's even better.
Yeah.
So hopefully that helps to promote the new album.
Yeah, and I think it will. I think it's a good song that sort of demonstrates how strong the album is, and I guess it's a bit of an eye-opener for a lot of fans, because this album as a whole sort of pushes the boundaries to what AMORPHIS has been doing for a long time now, but it sort of amps that up to a different level. You've used a lot of the strings and orchestral elements that have been around for some time now, but you've sort of amped that up to the max. So this time around you've also used a choir, a live choir. Can you tell us how you guys decided that might have been something that you wanted to use, and how you feel that that has enhanced the album?
Well, I think when we started to check out the new stuff, Jens already mentioned to us that he would like to use some of the like keyboard parts with replacing those with real instruments and chords and stuff like that, and we didn't think about that much at the time. But first time we heard about these new elements like chords and stuff, it was when we heard the mix first time. So I think we were quite blown away.
And you've spoken a lot about Jens, and obviously you guys went with Jens Bogren as producer again for this being his second album now with you guys. Jens is known as someone who is, I guess, pushes artists to the limit. So did you feel that this time around he brought a new element to you? Did he have much more control of the process this time around as opposed to last time?
It might be that it was even more pushing from Jens, but like last time with Under the Red Cloud, we were quite shocked how much he was wiping our asses. I mean, we started some days like 8 o'clock in the morning and we're working till 1 o'clock in the night. So, but we like that kind of working because this way we don't have a stress to ourselves, like how the recordings are going, because we have used to do records without any producer. So this was first time to us, like having that a guy who's producing that much. I mean, and we still didn't have to argue about things because we share the same opinions pretty much. So there wasn't things like we just didn't want to do, but we have to. But I think his ideas were great. It's like seventh member of the band and having like fresh ideas, which we were not thinking by ourselves. So I think, and also we knew Jens this time, so it was easier to start the whole process because we knew how he works, and he's very, very like almost like a perfectionist. So we knew that already. So we had like attitude for that kind of working already, so it was good again.
Yeah, good. So I guess we are talking about the new album, and it is important, I guess, to factor in that AMORPHIS has always been a band that has a very, I guess, grand story in place, where every part of the album, the track layering and all of that, is part of a greater puzzle. So with that being said, what can you tell us about Queen of Time that we might not already know?
What comes to my mind? Well, nothing comes to my mind, sorry.
No.
I don't know. It's just, I think I'm too inside of that album still. That's like listening and the mixes and things, so I really don't know what to say.
Yeah, fair enough.
Sorry.
No, that's all right. So, following the release of the album, you guys are touring pretty extensively. You've got a couple of dates in Japan, then you're heading back to Europe to do the European festival circuit, and then you're heading back to the US towards the end of the year with Dark Tranquility, Omnium Gatherum, and Moonspell. Are there any plans to add further dates or locations to those that have already been announced?
Well, yeah, I think after a States tour, I think we have a tour in Finland, and beginning of the next year, I think it's the first European tour, and there might be even two tours, I think, because we like to tour 5 weeks maximum in the time, so probably there will be like two European tours, and Russian, and I don't know yet that far, but there will be a lot of touring. I think we did, last 2 years, we did like 120 gigs. No, was it more? 220 gigs, yes. So I think we will be as busy this time.
Yeah, yeah. And we'll keep on the subject of the live setting at the moment. So I know that touring for the album has yet to begin, but AMORPHIS has in the past done some of those very big special shows. I mean, I was present during a couple of the European festivals where you played Tales of a Thousand Lakes and did that sort of special show a couple of years ago. But with such a big album, which has a lot of components to it, as we were talking about, the choirs, the orchestral elements, do you ever think that you might bring these songs to life with that full sort of the choirs, the orchestra, that sort of thing? Do you ever think that you might bring that to the stage?
Well, that would be great. At least like a couple shows or some like big shows. We have that like idea, but we haven't even started to practice the new stuff live. Still, we have like 1 week still off, and but definitely if we have like some opportunity to work with the same people who are guesting in this album, that would be perfect, but not in this summer, but maybe next summer. That would be nice to have some like working up or whatever great festival to have this, and maybe even record it as a DVD or something.
Yeah,
but would be great.
Yeah, definitely. Tomi, one more for you before we sign off here. If you had to pick a favorite song off the album, what would you tell the fans that it would be your favorite song?
Well, that changes all the time and depends the day, but I like the B, as that have like pretty much all elements we will have in the album as well, that, so that's very good introduction to album, I think, but also Daughter of Hate, as it's like same time it's brutal and it's progressive and a lot of things happening there and a lot of layers as well, so I would name those two, and maybe also amongst Stars, where Anneke is guesting as a female vocalist, so that's pretty something we haven't done ever before as well, so maybe those three songs.
Yeah, nice. Tomi, thank you so much for your time today. We've got Queen of Time coming out on the 18th of May. AMORPHIS is going to be touring pretty heavily afterwards, so we look forward to catching you out on the road soon.
Hey, thank you very much for this interview, and hope to see you on tour.